हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग एंड दिस इज डॉक्टर अपूर्व मडिया स्पीकिंग फ्रॉम अहमदाबाद। आई एम अ कंसल्टेंट कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट एंड फिजिशियन प्रैक्टिसिंग इन अहमदाबाद सिटी फॉर लास्ट 30 ईयर्स एंड आई हैव गॉट अ ह्यूज क्लिनिकल प्रैक्टिस अबाउट हार्ट पेशेंट्स एंड ब्लड प्रेशर, डायबिटीज एंड कोलेस्ट्रॉल। एंड आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विथ यू सम बेसिक एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट हार्ट अटैक। And particularly, I would like to explain to you what is heart attack, why it is occurring, and how we can prevent it, and what we can do to treat it. So to start with, we all know that incidence of heart attack is increasing day by day in our country. Many of the middle and old people are getting heart attacks, but the especially worrying part is that even younger patients, like at their 30s and 40s, are presented with heart attack in our medical emergency rooms. So it gives a little bit of a dilemma that why these young people are also getting a heart attack and why it is occurring so frequently. So first we shall understand the functioning of the heart to understand this. Now heart is a pump in the blood and which pumps the blood in our body so that the blood circulates all throughout our body system. And all the organs like liver, kidney, thyroid, pancreas, stomach, all of them need the blood, otherwise they can't survive. So this blood is supplied by the pumping of the heart. Now our heart, to do finish this task, our heart pumps about us at the rate of 72 beats per minute. So every minute the heart keeps on beating at the 72 beats per minute for the lifelong. So you can just imagine that how strenuous and important heart function is, that heart cannot even stop for a minute, otherwise the patient will not survive. So to do that, the heart has got the muscle, the valves and everything, all the equipment it has. But heart itself also has to survive. The heart muscle itself also needs the oxygen. So for supply of the blood and oxygen to heart muscle itself, the nature has given the heart what is known as coronary arteries. And these coronary arteries are they supply the blood to the heart muscle itself so that the heart can function without any issues. Now this blood supply of the heart coronary arteries, if they get blocked or for some reason or the other the supply is lost, a person gets a heart attack. So heart attack is by definition means simply that discontinuation of the blood supply to any part of the any portion of the muscle of the heart is called heart attack. And most commonly it occurs because of the clotting, what we call that a blood clot gets lost in the coronary artery and the blood supply gets cut off. Now why this happens? First of all, the coronary arteries are very smooth from inside. And though that smoothness allows the blood to flow very freely, and because the artery is very smooth, the whatever cholesterol in the blood is, it doesn't get stuck to the wall of the coronary artery. However, persons having high blood pressure, having diabetes mellitus, patient having very high stress levels, or a person very heavy smoking or even mild to moderate smoking, all these people gets their internal lining of the coronary artery gets eroded and the smoothness is lost. So this lost smoothness becomes the nidus point for the cholesterol to get deposited. And that cholesterol gets deposited on the wall of the artery. Gradually, that deposition of the cholesterol goes on increasing and the artery gets narrower and narrower. So once the artery gets narrow by 70 to 80%, there is a high chance that the blood clot can get lost into that narrowed lumen and the patient will get a heart attack. So this is the basic mechanism by how the patient can get a heart attack. Now we will see that what the symptoms are. Most of the common symptoms of the heart attack is excruciating severe chest pain for the patient. And patient cannot even sit up or stand up and they may even fall down or get unconscious. But it is not the only symptom. Many times the patient does not get any chest pain, but instead patient will get a stomach pain or get a jaw pain or get a profuse perspiration or even get a dizziness and unconsciousness, and chest pain may not be even there at all. So a doctor has to keep this in mind and check the patient from every point of view to rule out the heart attack. So once the heart attack is seen by the patient, doctor will conduct some tests. The first of all, it is the ECG is being taken. Most of the heart attack cases, ECG is very indicative and diagnostic. But somehow, sometimes the ECG doesn't show any changes, and the patient, we have to do echocardiogram. Echocardiogram also will show, echocardiogram is nothing else what we commonly call 2D echo, and it will show whether a heart attack is there or not. Other test is coronary angiography. That's the final gold standard test to detect a heart attack. And if the angiography shows a blockage, we can immediately put a balloon there, dilate the blockage and put a stent inside so it doesn't collapse again. So these are the symptoms and the tests that we do. Also, there are some blood tests which are conducted when a heart attack is suspected. They are called enzymes. It is called CPK-MB and troponin I. These are a blood test which will give you the indication whether a patient is having heart attack or not. And they are very useful many times when the ECG and echo doesn't show any changes, even though patient is having a heart attack. So this, after this is diagnosis is done, we have to treat the patient. So what are the basic treatment for the heart attack? They are, first of all, nitrates are given, that is also called as sorbitrate, that relieves the chest pain. Then we give beta blockers. After beta blockers, we give blood thinning agents like aspirin or ecosprin, clopidogrel. Even newer anticoagulant agent like rivaroxaban are given. Heparin is given injectably. When a patient acutely comes for the heart attack treatment, I mean in the emergency room, we sometimes give corticosteroids known as streptokinase or tenecteplase. They are given intravenously to immediately dissolve the clot which has been lost in the artery. So this is the basic treatment which are given. But most importantly, after we know all these things about the heart attack, what we need to do is to know very thoroughly that how to prevent it. So the most important aspect to prevent the heart attack, first and foremost, is the healthy lifestyle. So one must exercise regularly, keep the body weight in control. One should not eat a very oily and sticky food. One should keep the blood pressure under control, the diabetes under control. And if a person is smoking or using tobacco, that should be immediately stopped. Also, a person who is not having any of these bad habits like diet and tobacco, but the patient has a strong family history of the heart attack, he should be extra careful. And even though he is not having any bad habits or bad diseases, he should be very careful about his cholesterol and ECG and regular checkup to see if he is having the family tendency in developing a heart issue. So this is in nutshell all about the heart attack and its mechanism and prevention. And I hope you will find this information very useful and act accordingly to prevent a heart attack. And this information will also be useful to you if you are in a market or somewhere outside and another person is getting a heart attack. You will recognize it immediately and call the medical services accordingly. Thank you very much.